abiding Samaria, and she conceived by the Holy Ghost. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold the handmaid of the Lord. Be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of thy Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion do we come to know the glory of his resurrection, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Carissimi, beloved in Christ, welcome to this broadcast Mass on this, the Feast of Candlemas. We are about, in a moment, to bless the candles for the procession in honour of the Nunc Dimittis, indeed in honour of the revelation of the Messiah to the Gentiles and to the world. Today is the end of Epiphany, formally, and the end, we might say, of the Christmas season. So you've got till tonight to remove the rest of your Christmas decorations, if you have been keeping the old ways. We commemorate in the ceremony today that precedes the Mass the presentation of our Lord in the temple 40 days after having given birth. Mary and Joseph take our Lord, as was the law of Moses, to be presented in the temple, there too also for her to be ritually purified. Some of us are perhaps old enough to remember or have heard of the churching of women, which was a similar, basically the same ceremony. So with faith, we celebrate and commemorate the final revelation of this season of the Messiah to the world. With hope, we commemorate the revelation of the light to the world of our Lord. And we do this by, through, and with, and in charity, as an expression through this liturgical celebration of our love for God expressed in true worship. And of course, all of this with the faith, hope, and loving expectation of all that will be one day fulfilled in him, who is God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Dominus vobis cum, et cum spirito tuo, oremus. Domine Sancte Pater Omnipotens et Elegens, qui omnia rex nihilo creasti et iussu tu, per opera opum hunc linguorum, et perfectionem cerie venire fecisti, et qui hodierne die petitionem justis e meonis implesti, te cum milite deprecamur, ut as candelas ad usus hominum et sanitatem corporum et animandrum sive in terra, sive in aquis, per invocationem tui santissimi nomis, et per intercessionem beate Maries et Virginis, cuius hodie festa celebre, devote celebrantur, et per preces omnium sanctorum tuorum, benedicere, et sanctificare dignieris, et huius plebis tue que illas honorifice manibus desiderat potare, deque cantando laudare, exaudies voces de celo sancto tuo, et descendem estasis tue, et propitius his omnibus clemantibus a te, vos redemisti precios sanguine filii tui, qui tecum vivet et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Ardemus. Omnipotens sempre eterne Deus, qui hodierne diuni unigenitum tuum unis sanctis et meonis in templo sancto tu suscipientum presentasti. Tuum supplices deprecamo clemencia, ut as candelas quos nos famili tui in tui nominis magnificentiam suscipientes gestare, ubimus luci accensas, benedicere et sanctificare, atque lumine superne benedictiones excendere in miei, quae tamus eas tibi Domino Deo nostro ferendo digni, et sanctumine dulcissime caritatis tui succensi, in templo santo gloriae tue representari in meri api. Periundum Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivet regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Oremus. Domine Iesu Christe, lux vera quae illuminas omnem homine venientem in hoc mundo, effundem benedictionem, tuam sub hos cervios et sanctificar reus lumine gratiae tuum, et concede propitiumus, un sicut ec luminarie igne visibi accensa nocturnas de penum tenebras, id ad corda nostra invisibili inietides, Sancti Spiritus splendor et monostrasta, omnium viciorum cecitate eterna, ut pergatum et his oculo ea genere possibus, quae tibi sunt placitare nostri saluti utilia, quae temus post huius seculi carni nossem descrimina, ad lucem in intificiensi, per venire mere ab. Per te, Christe Jesu, salvatum mundi, qui in Trinitate perfecta vives a regnas Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Oremus. Omnipotens sempre eterne Deus, qui per nos in fabulum tuum purissimum olie liquorum et luminari ante conspectum tuum iugiter concinante per rarius isti, benedictionis tue gratiam sub hos cervios meninos effunde, quae temus sic administrent lumen externus, ut et donandi lumen spiritus tui nostris, non desit mensibus internus. Per Domino nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivet et regnat in unitate Custum Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Ordemus. Domine Iesu Christe, qui hodierne die in nostri cari substantiae domines apparens, et presentibus in templo est presentatus, quem Simeon venerabilis senex lumini spiritus vilitati agnus agnovis uscebit et benedicti, presto publicimus, ut eustum spiritus sancti grazie illuminati, atque dotie, te veritat, per agite et agnus camus et fidelite delicat, u qui cum Deo Pater, in unitate justum spiritus, sancti, vivis et regnus Deus per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Asperges me, Domine, qui sono et mundo, lavabis me et subvenir del alba.
Procedamus in pace, in nomine Christi, amen. Thank you.
Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti, Amen. Et toi, et pour la terre et d'elle, et d'elle, que l'idée de l'année, et tout de même. Iuri camerez, et vision de casa, mais de gentil en santa, per nomine, et de quoi de l'os, va tourner. Quoi tu es Deus, quoi tu tu, mea, quare de pelis, et quare tristis in cielo, quum frige per nous. Et me de luce, et tu veritate, et tu mis, et tu sei non, tu sei non, ti montum santo, tu amis, ta parava per la tua. Et in tua, con la terre e d'elle, e quelli divi, che l'ho tutto de même. Quoi vite, quoi ti vincite, la Deus, Deus, mea, quoi tristis anima, mea, quoi tu tu, Svere Deo quale va troppo bene qui, salutare Vultus me e Deus meus. Gloria Patri, Figlio e Spiritus Santo, sicur erat in principio e nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. In tuae volatari Dei, ed in qui divinari in tutto meum. Auditorium nostrum in nomine Domini, qui feci cieli e terra. Confiti in Deo, potenti via tua mania, sempre di genere, via tua carica, 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 via per voi troppo delle mea colpa, mea massima colpa. Ed io prego a te, Maria, se vi dici la mia vita, la canto, la mia vita, la Battista, il Santo Sposo, spesso il Paolo, e la mia Maria, il Piano, il Santo Sposo, Fabio, ora ripome e donne un del nostro. Mi sei tu, 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 mi sei Beato Giovanni Battista, Sanctis Apostolis, Spiritus Paolo, Omnibus Sanctis, et Divi Pater, qui am et Domini nimis cogitatione, verbo et opera, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. In Deo preco beatam, Mariam semper virginem, beatum Michaelem Arcangelo, beatum Giovanni Battista, Sanctis Apostolis, Spiritus Paolo, Omnes Sanctos, et Dei Pater, orare con me, Adonio, un Deo nostro. Miseriato vesti in potenza, se mi spiegati vesti, speduca e vostri vita metano. Ave, indulgenza, istruzione, trinissione, peccatorus, tuorum, tribiva, in nome, sotto di potenza, misericus, dormus.
Amen.
Deus, tu conversus per finita abismas,
et Deus, tu veritati por in te,
poi senti nomi sovra, misericordia tua,
et salutare tu, Adonis.
Domine, esali, razione, me,
et clave meus sancte et venia.
Dominus obiscu,
et cum spiritu tuo.
Ordenus. Suscepimus Deus misericordiam tuam in medio tempi tui, secundum nomen tuum Deus ita et laus tua in fine stere. Justitia pedres dextra tua, magus dominus et adabibilis nimis in civitate dei nostri, in monte santo eis. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritus Sancto, sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Suscepimus Deus misericordiam tuam in medio tempi tui, secundum nomen tuum Deus ita et laus tua in fine stere. Justitia pedres dextra tua. Gratis agimus tibi prote magum gloriam tuam. Domine Deus, Rex Celestis, Deus Pater Omnipotens, Domine Filii Unigenite, Iesu Christe, Domine Deus, Agnus Dei, Filius Patris, Victoris peccatum mundi, miserere nobis. Victoris peccatum mundi, suscipe deprecazione nostra. Quis eris et extra Patris, miserere nobis. Gloria tu solus sanctus, tu solus dominus, tu solus altissimus Iesu Christe, cum sanctu spiritu in gloria Dei Patris. Amen. Pax vobis et cum spiritu tuo. Alleluia. Omnipotens et eterne Deus, maiestatem tuum supplicet exoramus. Ut sicut unigenitus filius tuus hodierne decum nostri cari substantiae in templo est presentatus, Quitamus facias purificatis divinensimus presentare. Per iundum Dominum nostrum Iesu Christum finum tu, che tecum vivet alenia ad unitati Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia secura seculorum.
Amen.
Lectio Malachiae Prophetae. Et dici Dominus Deus, ecce ego mito angelum meum et preparabit fidam ante mia faciam mea, et satim veni et attentum suum dominatur quem vos quaeretis, et angelus testamenti quem vos votis. Ecce veni dici Dominus exercitum, et qui is poteri cogitare Deum adventus eus, et qui is stabile fidentum meum. Ipse enim quasi inis confranis et quasi herba fulonum, et sedebit confrase mundus argentum, et bugabit filius Levi et corabit eus quasi aurum et quasi argentem. Et erum Domino fiorenti sacrificium justitia, et placebit Domino sacrificium Iuda et Jerusalem, sicut die saeculi et sicut anni antiqui. Dici Dominus omnipotens.
Deo gratias.
Suscepimus Deus misericordiam tuum in medio templi tui, secundum nomen tuum Deus iter et laus tue in fine estere, sicut audibimus iter et fitimus in civitati dei nostri in Monte Santo eius. Alleluia, alleluia. Senex puerum potabiat, puer autem senem legebat. Alleluia. Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spirito tuo.
Sequentia Sancti Evangelii secundum Luca.
Gloria tibi Domine.
In illo tempore postquam in plesi sunt dies vocationes Mariae secundum legem Moysi toluerunt Iesum in Jerusalem. Ut sisterunt eum Domino, sicut scriptum est in lege Domini, quia omne masculinum ad pariens vulgum sanctum Domino vocabitur. Et ut arent hostiam secundum quoditum est in lege Domini, partuturum aut duus pulus columbarum. Et ecce homo erat in Jerusalem qui nomen Simeon, et homo visti justus et timoratus, expectans consolationem Israel, et Spiritus Sanctus erat in eo. Et responsum ecceperat et Spiritus Sanctum non fissurum se mortem, disi curius videret Christum Domini. Et venit in Spiritu in templum, et cum inducerunt governum Iesum parentes eius, ut facerem secundum consuetudinem legis prohem, et ipse accepit Deum in una sua, sed benedixit Deum et dixit. Nunc dimiti servum tuum Domine, secundum verbum tuum in pace, quia viderunt oculi mei salutare tuum, quod parasti ante facem omnium populorum, lumen et revelationem gentium et gloriam plebis tuae et Israel.
Laus
tibi Christi.
This feast of Candlemas, the feast of the presentation of our Lord in the temple and of the purification of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the lesson is taken from the book of the prophet Malachi. Thus says the Lord God, behold, I mean to send one of my angels to make the way ready for my coming. All at once the Lord will visit his temple, that Lord for whose presence you are ever longing, that herald of God's covenant who dwells so much in your desires. Yes, says the Lord of hosts, he is coming. But who can bear the thought of that advent? Who will stand with head erect at his appearing? He will put men to a test fierce as a crucible, searching as the lion that fullers use. From his judgment seat he will refine that silver of his and cleanse it from its dross, Like silver or gold, the sons of Levi must be refined in the crucible until they offer the Lord's sacrifice duly performed. Then once more the Lord will accept the offerings of Judah and Jerusalem as he did long since in the forgotten years, says the Lord, the Almighty. And the Holy Gospel today is a continuation of that according to St. Luke. At this time, when the time had come for Mary's purification according to the law of Moses, they brought Jesus up to Jerusalem to present him before the Lord there. It is written in God's law that whatever male offspring opens the womb is to be reckoned sacred to the Lord, and so they must offer in sacrifice for him, as God's law commanded, a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons. At this time there was a man named Simeon living in Jerusalem, an upright man of careful observance, who waited patiently for comfort to be brought to Israel. The Holy Spirit was upon him, and by the Holy Spirit it had been revealed to him that he was not to meet death until he had seen that Christ whom the Lord had anointed. He now came, led by the Spirit, into the temple, and when the child Jesus was brought in by his parents to perform the custom which the Lord enjoined concerning him, Simeon too was able to take him in his arms. And he said, blessing God, Ruler of all, now dost thou let thy servant go in peace, according to thy word. For mine own eyes have seen that saving power of thine which thou hast prepared in the sight of all nations. This is the light which shall give revelation to the Gentiles. This is the glory of thy people, Israel. Now Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. This is the light which shall give revelation to the Gentiles. This is the glory of thy people Israel. Charisma, beloved in Christ, welcome to this broadcast Mass on this Feast of Candlemas. As you noticed, of course, the Mass was preceded with the blessing of candles and procession in honour of the revelation of the Messiah to Simeon. Of course, in the temple too, not in this gospel pericope today, but Anna too, an old widow, was also privileged to behold and to recognize the Messiah as Simeon was. In our procession of candles, processing with the light, of course, to represent the light of the world. One perhaps thought of that passage from Isaiah, the people that walked in darkness have seen a great light, upon them hath the light shone. For we, my brothers and sisters, though we are a pilgrim people, though we are, as it were, dwelling in darkness whilst we are upon this earth, yet have been given the light of Christ. At our baptism, you possibly were too young to recall, but you would have been presented with a lighted candle taken from the Paschal candle. Some of you, of course, will remember the long liturgy of Holy Saturday and the vigil of Easter, whereupon the new fire is lit and the Paschal candle is blessed and lit, and the resurrection of Christ is proclaimed. We recall how Christ's coming into the world dispels darkness. So it is through the journey of our lives. We were given by Holy Mother Church, this is, my brothers and sisters, why sacramentals are so important. I mean, they are and they aren't. They aren't in the sense that, yes, we could live without sacramentals. I'm not talking about the sacraments, but we could live without sacramentals. Sacramentals, of course, being blessed objects like holy water or blessed candles or statues, etc. Yes, we could very well live without sacramentals. But at the same time, the sacramentals have a purpose because they remind us of truths and lessons of the faith. Holy water reminds us of our baptism, having died to the old self and been born anew in Christ. And so it is that holy water is usually made available at the entrance to our churches and chapels, so that as we enter, and of course in ancient times it was more commonly the font itself that was filled with water, we would bless ourselves upon entering church to remind us of our baptism, to, as it were, cleanse ourselves from the outside world, from the world, material world, as we entered into the realm of the kingdom of God, into the house of God. It's for that reason that, of course, that Muslims have ritually cleansed themselves. It's a sadness that we have, so many of us, forgotten such ancient customs, even though heretics have not. But the blessing of ourselves with holy water upon entering the church is a betoken of that time when we would have ritually cleansed ourselves, but also it speaks to us of our baptism and of that wholesome cleansing that we receive for our souls by our baptism and by the beginning of our salvation. Candles too then also have many purposes. Of course, we don't rely on them so much these days to light our way, to have light in the evenings. Most of us are fortunate enough to have gas or electricity, but nonetheless, candles serve by virtue of their purpose of giving light to remind us as sacramentals of Jesus, the light of the world. I often wonder sometimes if it had been a Catholic or an Orthodox pastor rather than a Lutheran one who invented the Christingle, whether today would have been a more appropriate day to hold a Christingle service, because of course it's all about representing Jesus, the light of the world. But as well, of course, candles then speaking to us of Jesus as the light of the world, of being given to us again at our baptism, of being lit at various points during the liturgy, not just in procession, reminding us of our pilgrimage of faith, but also too as we heard the gospel, suggesting again that we ourselves have been blessed to see the manifestation of Christ, of God incarnate in his word, in this case his spoken word. And then, which is why of course at sung masses, the gospel procession, the gospel book, is always accompanied by lighted candles or lighted tapers to remind us again of Christ, the light of the world, and also too of the revelation of his word, he who is the word revealed to us. And again, later on in this morning's Mass, our candles will be lit for the preface and the canon of the Mass, wherein we will see again the manifestation of the miracle of Bethlehem, when we will see the manifestation of God's divine charity, of God's sacrificial love toward us, made present upon the altar of the cross of Calvary, wherein and from which we see the high priest himself offering himself as a victim for the atonement of our sins, for the reconciliation of us with God, in the fulfillment of all that God had promised in his covenants with mankind. Notice in hearing the narrative about the gospel, and remember that what our Lord says often says about himself, and often we hear on the feast of saints, that he has come to fulfill, not to displace, but come to fulfill the law and the prophets. So it is that he is presented dutifully according to the law of Moses 40 days after his birth, brought because he is the firstborn male, honouring the covenant with Moses that such would be offered to God to seal the covenant. Also, too, is his mother taken to be again ritually cleansed and purified. Notice that they take with them two turtle doves. The law actually required a lamb, but if you were not rich enough to sacrifice a lamb, then you were permitted to offer turtle doves or pigeons instead. And here, of course, there is a slight irony, for here is the living temple, our Blessed Virgin. Here she is, who was a living temple to the presence of the Lord, she who was a living tabernacle to the presence of the Lord when God incarnate, the Word made flesh, was in her womb. Here she is in the temple, in the house of God, presenting he who would be the Lamb of God, he who would be the salvation of the world, he who would be, who would offer himself in sacrifice for our salvation. Today, my brothers and sisters, as we give thanks, as St. Simeon and St. Anna gave thanks in the temple for witnessing the revelation of the Messiah, of God incarnate made flesh, let us today, as we carry and light our candles, hold on fast to that hope, which saints throughout the centuries, even before his birth, had and trusted in God, and for that hope which those saints in the centuries since his revelation by his incarnate revelation had for heaven. Let us, when we light these candles, remind ourselves of that hope, of that transfiguration that we hope for of ourselves as the glorious resurrection of the body, when we shall be changed, when this corruptible shall be made incorruptible, as we will share in his radiance, in his light. Let us, as we light the candles at his manifestation among us, as the Word made flesh upon the altar of sacrifice, may we see with the eyes of faith that when we are invited to draw near and behold the Lamb of God, we may receive him in love, responding in love for his love toward us, who offered himself once for all upon the cross that we might live forever with him. Our Messiah, our God incarnate, our Lord Jesus Christ, who is God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Credo in unum Deum, Patrem omnipotentem, factorum caeli et terrae, visibilium omnium et invisibilium, et in unum Dominum Iesum Christum Filium Deum de unigenitum, et ex parte ante omnia saecula, Deum de Deum lumen de lumine, Deum verum de Deo vero, gentum dom factum consustantialem patrium, perquem omnia factus sunt, qui propte nos homines et propte nostrum salutem, descendi de celis, et incarnatus est de Spiritu Sancto ex Maria Virgine, et homo factus est. Crucifixus etiam pro nobis sub Pontius Pilatum passus et sepultus est, et resurrexit esse die secundum scripturas, et ascendit in genus edere dextra patis, et iterum venturus est cum gloria judicare vivos et mortuus, cuius regnum non erit finis. Et in spiritum sanctum dominum et vivificantem, qui ex patre procedi, qui cum patre et filio semel adorator con glorificatur, qui locutus est per prophetas. Et unam sanctam catholicam et apostolicam ecclesiam, confitio uno baptismo in remissione peccatorum, et expecto resurrectione mortuorum, et vita venturi secui. Amen.
Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spirito tuo.
Orde. Diffusere est gratia in habis tuis, proterria benedixit et Deus in eternum, et in saeculum saeculum.
Thank you.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Susum corda.
Habemus ad Domino.
Gratias agamus Domino Deum nostro.
Dignum et justum est.
Vere dignum et justum est equam et salutare nos tibi sempre dubic et gratias agere Domine Sancte Pater omnipotens et terrae Deus. Qui aper incarnati verbi mysterium, novamentis nostri oculis lux tuae claritatis infusi, ut un visibiliter Deum cognoscimus verbum invisibilium amorem rebeabur. Et in Deo Evangelis et Arcangelis controlis et dominationibus, cumque omni militia celestis exegitus, in un gloria et tuae canibus sine fine dicente.
Sanctus,
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 Dominus Deus Deo,
plenus in celi et terra gloria tua,
Hosanna in excelsis.
Benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini,
Hosanna in excelsis.
Thank you.
aeternia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Arde, spregem di sanitaribus maliti divina istruzione comandi. Ademus dice. Pater noster qui es in cieli, sanctificetur nomen tuum, nec venia regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Anum nostrum quotidianum de nobis hodie, dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentatione. Sed libera nos a mal. Saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum.
Et cum spirito tuo.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi,
Dona nobis pace.
Ecce omnius Dei, ecce qui tollit peccato mundi.
Domine non sedimus, ut in tres effectum meam, sed tanto de verbo, et sed abitur anima mea.
Domine non sedimus, ut in tres effectum meam, sed tanto de verbo, et sed abitur anima mea. Domine non sedimus, ut in tres effectum meam, sed tantum dic verbo, et sed abitur anima mea. Brothers and sisters watching Mass online and unable therefore to receive the Blessed Sacrament, we invite you now to make an act of spiritual communion, the words of which you will find below your viewing screen. My Jesus, I believe that thou art present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love thee above all things, and I desire thee in my soul. Since I cannot now receive thee sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though thou wert already there, I embrace thee, and unite myself wholly to thee.
Make not that I should ever be separated from thee.
Amen.
Sponsor macebit simione spiritu sancto non fissurum se mortem visi fidelit Christum do. Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo. Orde, Caesus Domine Deus nostre, ut sacrosanctum mysteriumque pro reparationis nostri munimine contulisti, intercedente beate Maria semper Virgine, et presens nobis remedium esse facies et futuro. Per Dominum nostrum, Iesum Christum Filium tuum, qui tecum vive et regni ad unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, terra omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo, ite missa est, Deo gratias. Sit nomen Domini benedictum, ex hoc nunc et usque in saecula, aut Domini nostrum in nomine Domini, qui feci caelum et terram, benedicat vos omnipotens Deus. Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen. Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo, initium sancti angelis secundum iuvandem, gloria a tibi Domine. In principio era verbum, et verbum era tabu Deum, et Deus era verbum. Hoc erat in principio verbum Deum, omnium visum factum sunt, et simul factum est nihilo factum est. In ipso vita erat lux factum, lux aeternum, est luce, et aeternum, et non comprehendem. Quid homo missus de per nomen erat Ioannes, sic veritim testimonium, un testimonium vivere du lumine, et omnes credunt in lui. Non erit in lux, sed testimonium vivere du lumine, de lumine. Erat lux vera, qua illuminat omnem hominem veniendum in mundum. In mundum erat, in mundus primum factum est, in mundus in nobis omni. In propria veritas omnes receberunt. Quod quod autem receperunt eum, detis multistatem filios de fieri, his qui credunt in Domine eius, qui non est sanguinibus, nec voluntati caris, nec voluntati viris, sed in Deo natus sunt. Et verbum carnum factum est, et habitavit in nobis et vinimus gloriam eius, gloriam primogeniti a Patris, per un gratia et veritatis.
Deo gratias.
Oh. strength to love thee come.